The show Baby Sharks in the City was specifically targeting the young of the year white sharks that we have here along the South Shore.
We're good.
Sharks are the gatekeepers of the environment. They're apex predators.
Your teeth on that baby?
They help to keep the organisms and animals underneath them in check in terms of population. They remove the weak and injured animals. He's scrappy, Dr. Toby Curtis. He planted the seed that the South Shore of Long Island could be a nursery for white sharks. And I was like, what's a white shark? You know, not a great white shark. He says, yeah, that same thing. I said, you mean to tell me I can go out here and catch baby white sharks? He says, yeah, and if you can, we're gonna be on a hell of a ride.
I got it.
So the sole purpose of the mission was to try and affix that camera tag to a young of the year white shark. As far as we know, that hasn't been done successfully. Baby white sharks are by far the hardest fish I have ever tried to catch, but they also have massive attitude, as you'll see in the show.
Look at how close that shark was.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, we're getting serious. I gotta pull out the sunglasses. My name's Greg Metzger, Chief Field Coordinator for SOFO Shark Program. You ready, Dad? We're the Shark Research and Education Program, and we take both very seriously. The summertime is when we have the opportunity to get out and collect data on the sharks. In the winter, we take what we've learned and we try to create public outreach and awareness. Typically, we will use the menhaden, which is what most of the sharks are here to eat. I grew up in Western New York, where we have more cows than people in the county, but I always wanted to be a marine scientist. And so I came to Long Island to get my bachelor's degree in marine science. I just drop that straight just till it touches and then lift it up about 18 inches. When I moved to Long Island, I started to get into fishing more and slowly moved up the food chain, ultimately ending with sharks. There's a watch in here. Being a marine scientist, I knew that every shark I caught and let go was data swimming away. Because all you ever hear about is nothing's known about sharks, nothing's known about sharks. And so if you're catching all these sharks, there's a possibility that the South Shore is a nursery for white sharks. It's just grown organically to create the research program that we have now. We'll go to the best place that we feel based on the environment, regular rods and reels and circle hooks, and we'll try to bring the animal alongside the boat. We keep the animals in the water, we secure them, and then depending on the species and size, we have a suite of various data that we'll collect from them and tags that we'll affix.
You know, if you're doing something like this with the idea that you're gonna catch a fish every time, you know, but if you do it because you enjoy it, that's what's good.
You guys ready?
Every day is an adventure, even though, you know, we've been doing it for quite a while now.
Real. Sand tiger, yoo-hoo!
When we secure the animal, we keep its head secure with the hook and the line, and then we'll put a rope around its tail, and we keep it in the water.
Just do what you're doing, Dad.
We'll take basic body measurements, length measurements, girth measurements. We record what species it is.
Okay, Dad, unhook.
Then we'll take blood samples, we'll take muscle biopsy, we'll take a fin clip.
Strong kick.
Take a cloacal swab.
Sex, you said male?
Male, yeah.
Depending on the species, we'll put an acoustic tag. So this gets a small incision through the body wall, and then the tag is inserted. It stays in the animal.
Girth, 86.
86, girth.
Hook is corner of the jaw. It's really just trying to get a baseline understanding of what depths and temperatures do the different species of sharks we have here prefer. So we can know what sharks might be showing up in the waters, when they might be here, when they might be moving out.
Number one!
It's a very, very active place. What's great is that we're able to start showing the world we have a spectacular show right here along the South Shore of Long Island. That's what we were hoping to show you.